This is Moonstalker at that place for walkthroughs with MaiLing of Dragon Age Origins. Had a crash. Went a little bit further than I intended to, and then remembered to restart the game. She went upstairs and cleared out the zombies. Got the loot from the main armory.
As you deserve.
Now she's headed back to Redcliff. Make sure that the Smith's daughter got home safely.
My Valena returned. She told me of your daring rescue. I can't begin to tell you how grateful I am. Take this. A reward for your deed. It's dwarven made and should serve you well.
I don't need a reward. Keep your armor.
That's even kinder of you. Thank you again. I'm forever in your debt.
Yes.
Indeed.
Indeed.
Blood Mage.
I await your command.
So, life in the wilds must have been very lonely.
At times, perhaps. A world full of people and buildings and things was all very foreign to me. If I wished companionship, I ran with the wolves and flew with the birds. If I spoke, 'twas to the trees.
And did they speak back?
Don't be foolish. I recall the first time I crept beyond the edge of the wilds. I did so in animal form, remaining in the shadows and watching these strange townsfolk from afar. I happened upon a noblewoman by her carriage, adorned in sparkling garments the likes of which I had never before seen. I was dazzled. This, to me, seemed what true wealth and beauty must be. I snuck up behind her and stole a hand mirror from the carriage. It was encrusted in gold and crystalline gemstones, and I hugged it to my chest with delight as I sped back to the wilds.
I don't imagine Flemeth was pleased.
She was not. Flemeth was furious with me. I was a child and had not yet come into my full power, and I had risked discovery for the sake of a pretty bauble. To teach me a lesson, Flemeth took the mirror and smashed it upon the ground. I was heartbroken.
I have a hard time picturing you heartbroken.
That is because I learned my lesson well. Beauty and love are fleeting and have no meaning. Survival has meaning. Power has meaning. Without those lessons, I would not be here today, as difficult as they might have been.
They made you stronger, didn't they?
They did indeed. To return to your original question, perhaps my time in the wilds was indeed lonely, but such was how it had to be. I find myself at times wondering what might have become of the girl with the beautiful golden mirror, but such fantasies have no place amidst reality.
You are not quite as callow as I thought. That is unexpected.
Callow? You thought I was callow?
You sound surprised. You must have heard this before. You'll get over it. Eventually.
Why did you come to Ferelden?
I was sent to be the eyes of the Antom. The Arishok asked what is the Blight. By his curiosity, I am now here.
Don't you have to report back, then?
Yes.
Well, I can see you right on top of that.
I cannot go home.
Well, I'm sorry.
Thank you. Can we move on? We keep the Darkspawn waiting.
What were you doing in that cage?
Does it matter?
Yes.
Very well. I caged myself. A weak mind is a deadly foe, as you are no doubt aware.
Exactly what happened?
I came to your lands with seven of the Beresad, my brothers, to seek answers about the Blight. We made our way across the Ferelden countryside without incident, seeing nothing of the threat we were sent to observe. Until the night we camped by Lake Callenhad. They came from everywhere. The earth beneath our feet, the air above us. Our own shadows harbored the Darkspawn. I saw the last of the creatures cut down, too late. I fell.
That sounds like what happened to us at Ostagar.
I heard the stories of Ostagar. Your kith stood their ground when others fled. No one can do more than that. I don't know how long I lay on the battlefield among the dead, nor do I know how the farmers found me. I only know that when I woke, I was no longer among my brothers, and my sword was gone from my hand.
What did you do?
I searched for it. And when that failed, I asked my rescuers what had become of it.
Did the farmers know where it was?
They said they found me with nothing.
Did you believe them?
I did. I knew they didn't have the blade. They had no reason to lie to me. I panicked. Unthinking, I struck them down.
That's terrible.
I know I cannot justify what I have done. My honor is forfeit. That sword was made for my hand alone. I have carried it from the day I was set into the Beresad. I was to die wielding it for my people. Even if I could cross Ferelden and Tevinter unarmed and alone to bring my report to the Arashok, I would be slain on sight by the Antam. They would know me as soulless, a deserter. No soldier would cast aside his blade while he drew breath.
Couldn't you search for it?
If I knew where to look, it would be in my hand now.
Where did you fight the Darkspawn?
Near Lake Callenhad.
Don't worry. We'll find it.
Perhaps those words are empty, but thank you all the same.
You're welcome. Let's see. Presents.
Is that for me? Really? Wow!
All right, yeah.
A fine gift. You have my thanks.
Unexpected. Thank you. You have my thanks.
You have excellent taste. How nice. How nice. Thank you.